Now we are going to study certain factors about plane curves. Remember that there are different types of curves. One, the two-dimensional curves known as the plane curves, and the second one, the three-dimensional curves known as the space curves. We are going to deal with plane curves. You are going to study the curvature of a plane curve, which means that how much the curve is curved. That is what curvature means. That is, suppose you have a graph like this. You can see that here the graph is not much curved, but in this part the graph is really curved, which means that the curvature at this part is more than the curvature at this part. So you define curvature in terms of the unit tangent. So suppose you take a point here and find out the unit tangent of this point. You can see that this is a unit tangent. I have marked it in pink color. Now suppose you take another point here. You have a unit tangent which is in pink color here also. Since it is unit tangent, the magnitude will always be the same at every point. Only the direction can change. Here the direction is towards this part, whereas here the direction is towards this part. You can see that there is no much difference in the directions here. But considering this point and this point, you can see that the unit tangent vector at this point is directed upwards, while the unit tangent vector at this point is directed downwards. That means there is a vast difference between their direction. So suppose you are taking the rate of change of tangents, unit tangents. You know that unit tangents, there is no change in magnitude. So rate of change means it depends only upon the direction of the unit tangent. So the curvature is defined as the rate at which t turns, or the tangent, unit tangent turns per unit length along the curve. That is the rate at which, the rate of change of the unit tangent per unit length of the curve. That is called curvature. So curvature is denoted as kappa, and it is given as the magnitude of dt by ds. Okay, now dt by ds can be written as dt by dt into dt by ds, since here t can be differentiated with respect to s only if t is in terms of arc length, or in terms of arc length parameter s. Suppose you are not given in, it is not given in arc length parameter, and it is given in terms of time as usual, then again you can differentiate this using chain rule as dt by ds is equal to dt by dt into dt by ds. But you know that dt by ds, as studied just earlier, is 1 by magnitude of v of t. Thus you can say kappa is also equal to 1 by magnitude of v of t into magnitude of dt by dt. So the curvature of a given curve is either magnitude of dt by ds or 1 by magnitude of v of t into magnitude of dt by dt. Now if this kappa is large, you can say that the curve turns sharply, since here there is a rapid difference, or the rate of change of tangents is very much large, which means that the curve is curved very much. Here the rate is very small, which means the curve is not much curved. That is what is said here, that is kappa, if kappa is large, then the curve turns sharply, and if kappa is closer to zero, that is if kappa is very small, then the curve turns slowly at that point. Now let us do some examples using these facts. First example is that the curvature of a straight line is zero. You know that curvature kappa is magnitude of dt by ds. Suppose this is a straight line. You take a point here, then the tangent to this point will trace the straight line itself. You can see that I have marked it in pink color. Suppose you take another point here, again the tangent at this point to the straight line will again trace the straight line itself. So the unit tangent of any point on the straight line will have the same magnitude, since it is unit and the direction is also same. Therefore, there is no change in magnitude as well as direction. That is, there is no rate of change for this unit tangent vector. That is what is said here. Therefore, dt by ds will be equal to 0 since there is no change in direction as well as magnitude. That is, kappa, which was equal to magnitude of this dt by ds, will be equal to 0. That is, curvature of a straight line is 0. You can directly see it from the figure, or you can see, you know that the straight line is never curved. So, always the curvature is 0. So to find kappa, let us first of all find what the arc length parameter is. Arc length parameter is defined as s of theta is equal to integral 0 to theta magnitude of v of t dt. There is just change of variables here. You know, earlier r was given in terms of t. That is why we found out s in terms of t. Here r is given in terms of theta. So to find out s in terms of theta, you should have theta in the upper range. And here whatever variable it is does not matter. So, I have given the base point as 0 since there is no other base points given here. I have given it as the starting point. So, s of theta is equal to integral 0 to theta magnitude of v of t dt, where v of theta is the derivative of the given curve, that is dr by d theta, and it is equal to minus a sin theta I cap plus a cos theta j cap. So, magnitude of v of theta, which is equal to root of a square sin square theta plus a square cos square theta, is equal to a. So, here there is no terms of theta. Therefore, magnitude of v of theta as well as magnitude of v of t will be the same. So, here I can write this implies that magnitude of v of t is equal to a. And substituting in this formula, I have this is equal to integral 0 to theta a dt, which is equal to a t from 0 to theta. That is, you are integrating dt, which is equal to a into theta. So, you have s in terms of theta, and thus theta will be equal to s by a since s was equal to a theta. Now, you are substituting for this theta in the given curve. R of theta was a cos theta I cap plus a sin theta j cap. Substituting for theta, you have a cos s by a I cap plus a sin s by a j cap. Thus, you have reparametrized the given curve and you name it as R of s or U of s. It doesn't matter. Now, you have to find t. T is equal to, you know, it is dr by ds. And it is equal to, by differentiating r with respect to s, it is equal to cos s by a's derivative is minus sin s by a, and you have to derivate this also, that is into 1 by a. You already have a here, so cancelling the a's. Plus a into the derivative of sin s by a, you have to use the chain rule, is cos s by a into 1 by a. Again cancelling the a's, you have t of s is equal to minus sin s by a I cap plus cos s by a j cap. Thus, to find kappa, kappa is the magnitude of dt by ds. First of all, you have to differentiate t with respect to s. So, this is equal to magnitude of, differentiating this with respect to s, this is equal to minus cos s by a into 1 by a, just like before using chain rule, plus minus sin s by a into 1 by a j cap's magnitude. The magnitude of this is equal to root of cos square s by a into 1 by a square plus sin square s by a into 1 by a square. Taking 1 by a square outside, you have cos square s by a plus sin square s by a whole inside the root. So, this is equal to root of 1 by a square, which is 1 by a. Thus, you have the curvature of the circle is 1 by a. Now, you need not do all these complicated steps. There is an easier method. Since you know that kappa is equal to 1 by magnitude of v into magnitude of dt by dt, where t is equal to v by magnitude of v. So, by using this formula also, you can find the answer. Let us see how it is. R of theta was given to you as a cos theta I cap plus sin theta a sin theta j cap. Now to find the t, you need v by magnitude of v. For that, the velocity is the derivative of r. It is minus a sine theta I cap plus a cos theta j cap. So the unit tangent t of theta is equal to v by magnitude of v, which is equal to minus a sine theta I cap plus a cos theta j cap from here by magnitude of v. You know that magnitude of this is a, since root of a square sine square theta plus a square cos square theta is a. This is equal to, by cancelling a's, you have minus sine theta I cap plus cos theta j cap. Therefore, kappa, which is 1 by magnitude of v into magnitude of dt by d theta, is equal to 1 by magnitude of v is a into magnitude of dt by d theta. T is already given here. Differentiating this again with respect to theta, you have minus cos theta I cap minus sine theta j cap, which is equal to 1 by a into root of cos square theta plus sine square theta, which is 1. Therefore, it is equal to 1 by a. So, again, easily you can see that the curvature of a circle with radius a is 1 by a.